Thank you, Larry. EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to the Lone Star State and Mammoth AT&T Stadium in Arlington, Texas. Tonight, on this fine Thursday night, we've got a good one in store between the Tampa Bay Buccaneers and the Dallas Cowboys. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28-yard line. They run with a rookie. Here's Elliott. Not much room here as he only gets it to about the 30. Well, Zeke continues to lead the NFL in rushing by a wide margin against the Giants on Sunday night. Racked up his fifth 100-yard outing of the year, but 24 carries to get to 107.
And they don't mind that at all, because with 24 carries, that usually means Dallas is controlling the clock and controlling the scoreboard. In this game, what the Giants did was let him have his carries, but they kept him from getting those super explosive plays. His best run of the night, just 15 yards. They made him really work for it.
Oh, he'll want that one back. Incomplete. He doesn't drop too many in that department. Third down. An early tough test on the opening drive. This is third and eight. Play fake. Here's Prescott. And that's caught by Beasley. And he's got the first down, yardage before being taken down at midfield. He's such a good route runner. Shows it there on third down. Very proficient and a good pass.
And you know what I've observed over the years in the NFL? The better a route runner you are, the more confidence your guy's going to have in you to go to you in important times, because he can trust you being in the right spot. And they connected there and picked up the first down.
A first down carry by Elliott. And good penetration here. He'll get this down only to about the 49-yard line. Charles, I know it's hard when live bullets are flying, but you cannot keep your hand up around the face mask area.
It is absolutely inexcusable nowadays. We talk about target areas all the time. You have to aim lower so that your hand doesn't get involved in the face mask.
And now a first down following that long gain. After the penalty, it's Elliott. Ooh, with a juke. And he'll get this down to about the 30, 31-yard line. Give him three on first down. It'll set up a second and seven. So the offense now dealing with a second and seven. Now it's a bootleg with Prescott. Sideline throw, it's complete. And a nice job there of keeping the toes in bounds.
I do have to admit, I like it when it all comes together. When the top part, catching the football, right, whether you're catching it with your hands or cradling it, comes together with the legs, in this case the feet, doing a little toe tap to stay in bounds and complete the catch.
And a great job by our crew on the camera shot. Love when you see the grass or on the field turf, those rubber pellets flying up. Great catch. And he's going to get the first down as they bring him down at the 23.
Everyone understood their role on that play. Third and one. You know, the defensive guys, they're trying to get down and get low and get leverage on the offensive lineman, but they didn't allow that to happen. They created a crease and allowed him to get through for a first down.
Prescott on first down. Throwing the slant pattern here, complete. A gain of six there on first.
Some think the teams really won't throw a slant route unless you have a receiver that has a lot of stature to him. But sometimes the little guys, they get lost in there. People can't really locate them, and they run that quick cut on the slant, and oftentimes they can turn it into big plays.
And the defense with their backs against the wall a little bit here as the offense is in the red zone. Second down, Prescott. This will be caught just inside the 10. And here he'll get it down to the 7. 9 yards on the play there, and it sets him up first and goal.
I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed out position because he creates mismatches with his size. But slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running savvy.
Go down, go down. Come on,
So now it's first and goal. Now Elliott. And that'll move him a little closer as he takes it from the 7 down to the 4-yard line. Now this will be the 9th play on this drive. Now it's the Florida Atlantic alum. This is Alfred Morris. And he will take it in for a Cowboy score. Alfred Morris, a 3-yard touchdown run. And the Cowboys have taken the early lead. That's just a solid, methodical drive to start this game.
And how about how it culminated? Doing exactly what they wanted to do, getting the ball downfield, and then running it into the end zone. I'm just telling you, partner, when you run it in rather than throw it in, that hurts a defense psychologically a heck of a lot more.
Bailey now to kick it away after the touchdown. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll elect not to return this one, so they'll bring it out to the 25 on the touchback. Here comes the Tampa Bay offense now heading back out onto the field. Here on first down. Stocker's got it. Complete. And he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here. And a big face mask penalty here, 15 yards.
You never want to get your hands up in the face mask area because your fingers can get tangled up there, and that can hurt you as a player.
Now with Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. It's the Bucs in possession of the football as we begin the second quarter. They take over first and 10 up near midfield. One man on the backfield, that's Martin. And he'll get it up the middle. And he might have got this across midfield, not by much. They'll mark it down at the 49. For Martin in week 14, had a couple decent carries, but all in all, not the greatest of outings. Less than 3 yards per tote, 66 on 23 carries.
And coming off of last year's monstrous year where he was a Pro Bowler, all pro, they expected more of the same. But he hurt a hamstring early in the season. That set him back. So in 7 games this year, the 66 yards he just had against New Orleans, that was the second highest total in a game for him this season.
And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
That was a classic example of trying to run with the ball without securing the catch. He was thinking about those rack yards instead of making the catch first and then taking off.
Third down here for the offense after the incomplete pass. On third down, Winston. He's got time in the pocket. And he'll just toss it away. So he throws it away, and that brings him fourth down. On fourth down, one of the Bucs' offseason signees. It's the former Jag, Brian Anger, to punt it away. Lucky Whitehead back deep for Dallas. And no return here. Where will they spot it? They say just outside the 20-yard line. Here's the Dallas offense now heading back out onto the field. And that recipe on their last drive that resulted in a touchdown looked pretty good, so they'll be hoping to do that once more.
And it takes me back to when we sat with the offensive coordinator and the head coach. They felt pretty good about their game plan, and
Thought there were some holes in the defense, and they exploited them the last time out. Let's see if they can come back and put together a similar drive.
And we'll see if they can do just that. They start on the ground with Elliott, and he is going to lose yardage here. It's a loss of four there, bringing up second down.
That was a nice play by the defense, but the offense can't let that one play define them. Let it go, move on, and start over again.
Second down throw for Prescott. He's going to launch this thing. Wait, he's got him in. Complete. And they finally do get him, but not before he reaches the 27. A big play here for Dallas. 54 yards. Well, we know he's got the speed there. He needed the speed and the hands. A great catch.
And because of that speed, you have to respect it as a defender. So you have to either play off or make sure you're somehow in contact with him, and he's able to do exactly what you said. Use the speed to his advantage and go up and get the football. That's a big-time play right there.
Dez Bryant, the intended receiver, and now it's second down. And he's certainly not a guy that drops that football very often.
Indeed, because that's a bit of a surprise. I know he's in the middle of some traffic and people, bodies all around him, but he usually has the focus to haul that one in.
They come out here in the eye. Here's Prescott. And he's just going to get rid of this thing to no one here. He throws it away, and now it's third. Offense trying to avoid stalling out, facing a third and 10. It's a five-receiver set, three to the left, two to the right. On third down, it's Prescott. And now another one thrown incomplete. Jason Witten, the intended target. And that'll bring up a fourth down. Now Dan Bailey, 30 of 32 in field goal tries last year. This from 44 yards out, left hash. And Bailey able to knock it through. And the lead moves to 10-0. So no problems there with that one as they're able to put three up on the board.
Yeah, it's pretty much a windless night. There's only a very light breeze, so it's a perfect night for kickers. And like you say, no problems with that one.
Now, after the field goal, Bailey will kick it away. On the return, it's Ryan Smith. And a pretty good return here. He'll be stopped just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. Now the Buccaneer offense set to take over again. And the last drive, the first drive for them, not very good. Three and out. What do they go to here?
Well, you don't look down at your play sheet and say, this is what the problem is. Now let's find out who my playmakers are. Get the ball in their hands, and maybe the offense will move a little bit
better. Sometimes it's more important to get it to the right people rather than dialing up the right number.
Exactly.
Or the right play, yeah.
That too.
So out come the Bucs now. And a three and out on that first drive. We'll see if they can do better here.
They should have a better opportunity because the nerves should be settled now. That first series, everybody goes out with a little extra emotion. So now they get a chance to go back out and say, okay, now we're into the game. Let's go play and play as best we can.
You almost get a mulligan then on that first drive?
Sometimes it absolutely serves that way. You get a second opportunity. Nothing big happened. But then again, you didn't commit any mistakes either. Off you go.
Following the penalty, Martin. And he is going to lose yardage here. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
With the struggles we're seeing up front for the offense today, they've got to think about changing up their play calling. Some screens, some draws, some quick hitting plays in order to try and supplement the run game. You don't totally abandon it, but you try and give it a little bit of help.
Now Jameis on second down. It's caught by Mike Evans. That catch good for five. It's third down. And now we're circling here around the two-minute warning.
This is a setup play, trying to get one last one in before the clock warning.
I see an extra defensive back on the field. Little surprise here on third and one. It's caught. Shepard. And brought down, but the juke, the very nice juke, gives him the first down yardage there. And the offense moving quickly to the line. Now a play fake here on first down. He's got time. Still back there. And that's caught inside the 30. And he's going to be marked down deep in Dallas territory. So there you go, holding by the offense, and that'll push him back.
Changes everything now as you try and figure out what your playbook has for you. Longer yardage situations, tougher to execute and pick up first downs.
One receiver left, three to the right.
Ready, ready.
Working out of the gun, Winston. And a catch right side by Evans. It's a solid pickup of 11, and it's second down. And they're going to hurry back to the line now. To the air again with Winston. Finding time. Goes underneath to Martin. And the play goes nowhere. Losing yardage back near the 40 at the 39. Call that a loss of 5 yards on the play. And it'll be a third and about 13. Third and long for Winston. And a quick throw here, that's complete. And now a timeout called by the Cowboys defense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. Here's Brian Anger now, as he'll punt it away for the second time. That one sails out of bounds. The side judge will walk it off, and he says it went out of bounds at the 9-yard line. Nice punt. And now Dallas gets set to take the field. And we'll see how this is played. Offensively, they've got the lead. Not a whole lot of time left. What do you think, Charles?
Well, it's tempting to try and add to your lead, but a mistake there, that could change things in a big way. I say go ahead, take the knee, get on out for the half.
Come on, let's go! One, nine.
Prescott looks to throw on first, and he's got his man on the out route. And he's taken down, but able to get this up to the 20-yard line. And now here come the Cowboys. And we'll see how this is played. Offensively, they got the lead. Not a whole lot of time left. What do you think, Charles?
Well, it's tempting to try and add to your lead, but a mistake there, that could change things in a big way. I say go ahead, take the knee, get on out for the half.
Fresh set of downs here.
Hey, watch 11, watch 11. Trip. Come on, let's go. Brad 38.
Prescott on first down. And this one caught by Dez Bryant. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. He was targeted 9 times, was Dez, against New York. Just 1 catch for 10 yards. Also had a fumble.
2 catches against New York in 2 games this year for Dez Bryant. Janoris Jenkins, a pickup for the Giants in the offseason at cornerback, has done a nice job against him. But I will say this, if they go a third time, they better be prepared in New York, because Dez Bryant, his pride and ability could be a breakout for him.
And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. The 4-time Pro Bowler, Gerald McCoy, in there to sack him for a loss of 6. So we have reached halftime with our score 10-0. As we send you on over to Orlando, where we'll check in with Larry Ridley. He's got our EA Sports Halftime Report. Larry, so both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number three. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he'll be brought down at the 23, make it the 24-yard line. Out come the Buccaneers. They'll have it first to start the third quarter. They have the ball here for the inaugural drive of the second half. Pretty big deficit, though. We'll see what adjustments were made in that locker room.
And I never want to make something more important than it actually is, right? I don't want to create more hype than what is there.
But this
is
a
I'm doing it though. This is a really important drive. And we often talk about teams scripting plays to start a game. A lot of them script to start the second half, too. And they're scripting something that they expect to get them into the end zone and back into this game.
And got his man complete. And he's taken down, but not before getting this across midfield and just shy of the 40. And at this stage, down in the second half, looks like they just wanted to find a way to get it in the hands of their playmaker, and they did.
I think you're exactly right. I don't think the coordinator's looking at his play sheet and trying to figure out which play will work well. He's trying to figure out how to get the ball to the playmaker that you just described. Looking down at that sheet, you find people plays, not necessarily X's and O's, and that's exactly what they did there.
And he only manages a couple here, down to about the 38-yard line. So the offense looking at a second and 8. Now a second down throw for Winston. And the hit jarred loose. It's incomplete.
And he still doesn't have a catch. We're into the second half. I think it's a little bit of a surprise to me, but that was one he should have caught.
Absolutely. That was his best opportunity right there. He dropped it. First down marker at the 31. It's third down. On third down, Winston. A dump off to Sims. And he gets the first down here as he's taken down at the 24. It's a pickup of 15 and a fresh set of downs.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware, ball may come your way.
Inside 4 minutes to go, third quarter. They come out here in the eye. They go play action here on first down. He's going to take a shot for the end zone. Mike Evans, the one he was looking for. And that'll bring up second down.
A missed opportunity for an interception would have killed off a drive. They had a chance there to finish things off. Didn't get it done. I guess that's why a lot of those guys did not play offense.
Second down here after the incomplete pass. Second down, Winston again. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by Brandon Carr. And he'll get this back across the midfield, striping down to the 47-yard line. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. Thought they had something going there to break that goose egg here in the second half, but to no avail.
Hope was alive until that interception. What a terrific.
And he's going to go down. Back across midfield. He sacked at the 46. And we say it all the time, have to be able to get rid of the ball sooner than that.
You have to help your offensive line out. They're going to protect you as best they can. And if you're getting 3 to 5 seconds to throw the ball, they're doing a really nice job. But when you hold it and give up a sack, you're really almost discrediting their work.
Off play action to Elliott. Here's Prescott surveying the field. All kinds of time. He's going to sling this deep downfield. And oh, not only did he drop it, he dropped it in the end zone.
And when all else fails as a defender, when you're not there in the coverage, your best friend is exactly what we saw there. A big play shot taken by the offense. Unfortunately, it ended in a big drop.
And the box with an extra defender in the secondary now on third down. Play fake. Here's Prescott. He's got time in the pocket. Great protection. And that's caught by Beasley. And that one results in 35 yards.
Now that play will end up on the highlights, and you'll see it all over the place. But what you won't see, the offensive line that bought the extra time that allowed for the big completion downfield, those guys made that play possible.
So they're operating in the red zone. One man in the backfield, Elliott. Here's Prescott. This will be caught inside the 10. Give him 9 there on the first down completion. Second down, Elliott. And he'll be brought down this time at the 5-yard line. 4 yards on the play, and that leads to the first and goal.
Now that's the way to do it. Hand it to someone with vision and good footwork and handling a little bit of power, and you find a way to pick up first downs.
They keep on the ground with Elliott. And he is going to lose yardage here. It's a loss of 2 there, bringing up second down.
There's so many times during camp and practice that you get bored as a player doing regular drills. But how about that shed and skate drill right there by the linebacker? You do it each and every day, get the blocker away, and get into the backfield and make a big-time tackle. That's what we just saw.
Back now in Arlington. It's the Cowboys with a football. They'll be looking to tack onto their lead as we get set for the fourth.
Let's go! Red 38!
Elliott. And this has been a recurring theme tonight for sure. Nowhere to run. Back to the line of scrimmage, that's all.
You know that old expression, it's not my night? It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
And every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play. Prescott on 3rd and goal. This will be caught at about the 6. 2 yards is all they'll get on the completion. It's 4th down.
So much about this game is just understanding situations and then having to execute, isn't it? Guard the first down sticks. Don't let them get there. And they rallied and made the tackle.
So on 4th down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. From the left hash, should be a fairly easy one here. And Bailey able to knock it through. And that'll push the lead up to 13-0. So they settle for just the 3 there, but clearly anything helps when you're trying to salt one away here in the fourth.
Without a doubt, I think a touchdown would have been the final nail. But 3 does give them some breathing room and lets them build up a little cushion.
Now after the field goal, Bailey will kick it away. Now it's Adam Humphries on the return. And he'll take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. And Tampa Bay trots out there now. Looked like they had something going last drive. Then the interception happened. Will they recover?
The memory they need to keep with them is that they did have something going. They were moving the ball on offense, had a nice sequence going. Don't worry about the other part. You can't get that back. Let's go back to what you were doing well before.
I thought you were going to say they need to have no memory, but remember the good part, forget the bad.
I like that even better.
Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. He was trying to get it to Doug Martin. That'll bring up second down. So incomplete on first. Let's see what second down has in store. Throwing again. Winston on 2nd and 10. It's brought in by Adam Humphries. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. Really nice little connection there. They go with the corner route, and it works out well.
And the best way to set up the corner route is to throw slants throughout the ball game so that when you're able to get back outside, the defender has to respect the inside game.
They'll put two receivers left, two to the right. Winston now to throw on first down. Evans has it left side. And taking it across midfield and just shy of the 40. First down, Winston. He finds his target. It's Evans. And he's going to get this inside the 30. Give him 11 on the gain there. And that'll be good enough for a Tampa Bay first down. First and 10, Winston. He completes it to Evans. And he's able to get it to the edge of the red zone at the 20-yard line. It's a gain of 9 yards. And it'll be second and about a yard to go for the first. Again, it's Winston. And this is caught by Evans. And he'll get it down this time to the 17. Only 3 there on the pickup, but that's enough to move the chains. And now it looks like they're going to be in the hurry up. Jameis now on first down. And he just throws this one away. Smart decision here this close to the end zone, and it brings up second down. Able to connect on the first down pass play. Now it's second down. Throwing again. Winston on second and 10. They set up the screen to Martin. It goes as a loss of 6. And now third down. And on third down, the Cowboys bring in an extra defensive back. Third and long for Winston. And this is caught at the 8. Well, he's taken down, but not before picking up the first thanks to a flashy little spin move. And now they're in the hurry up. Jameis again. Oh, it's incomplete. That would have been big in the end zone if he could have held on. Instead, it's second down.
Not only did they drop what looked like an interception in the end zone, they blew a golden opportunity to shift the momentum.
Just play after play after play on this long drive for the offense. Now whistles here before the snap. Looked like one of the Bucks may have moved. And they're behind the sticks here a bit now, dealing with a second and 12. They'll put two receivers left, two to the right. They'll throw again. Winston, he's got time. And he'll slide down to avoid the contact. It's a gain of 6 on the play, and that is going to set up third and goal. Looking to speed things up here, going with some tempo. Jameis to throw it. And this is caught now for a late touchdown. So hold everything here. This one's not over yet.
And there's the touchdown that they needed. So they'll celebrate, but the guys on the sidelines, they've got to stay focused. The onside kick team, they need them to get the ball back.
Yeah, part one of the equation done. Now they need to convert, then get that onside kick. And that'll make it 13-7. So a little under 50 seconds to go. Plenty of time if they can get this onside kick. Oh, I think the Bucs got it, and they did. Tampa Bay football. Now the Buccaneers offensive unit back out on the field. So they've accomplished half the mission, Charles. They get the onside kick. They do need a touchdown here, but they've got some time to do it.
In the excitement, there's no need to press. Plenty of time. They have the opportunity. Now they just need to execute and finalize things.
They'll look to throw. Finding time. He's going to let it fly. And that one falls incomplete. Looked like he might have had position there, but he couldn't hold on it at second down.
One thing I know from experience is that when the deep ball is thrown and you're the defender, you've got to fight that little bit of panic that emerges. You've got to play the ball really well. It's a 50-50 jump ball play. And guess what? They took a shot. How are you going to win it? And in this case, they managed to get it done.
False start's going to push them back. But these days, how hard must it be to be an offensive lineman?
It's very hard, Brandon. You've got defensive linemen flinching, trying to draw you offside. You've got the loud crowds. And there are just so many super athletic players on defense now that you have to deal with each week. But through it all, these guys just sit in there for four quarters and slug it out.
So the defense has put them in a tough spot. It's second and long. He'll look to throw. Toward the sideline, and look at that catch. Dragging the toes, and that's going to be a first down. Well done. That's what they need right now. Get the first down, get out of bounds, stop the clock.
Just playing smart football, understanding the situation, making the plays necessary, and making sure that clock stops at every opportunity.
Side. And he is in as they have tied it late here in the final minute of the fourth quarter.
And now we've got a tie game after that touchdown. And you and I both know what that means. Extra point in this situation, this little time left, takes on some extra emphasis, doesn't it?
It does indeed. Now inside the final minute, can they get it? And now the kick is blocked. And the Cowboys, and now nothing but green ahead of him. The 40, he's at the 30. And into the end zone. It's an impossible turn of events. With those 2 points, they take the lead. So with under 30 seconds to play, this is the game right here. And this is going to be recovered by the hands team. And that should just about put a capper on this one. Now the Cowboys offense heads back onto the field. Well, fourth quarter, they felt like they needed the football back. Unfortunately, they couldn't get it.
And I know we've brought analytics into the game, and someone has said here that the data says that when a team's expecting an onside kick, 80% of the time, the team expecting it, they do actually recover the ball, which is what we saw here. I just wonder if that number is much more of an anecdotal type of a number. Kind of like when the coaches tell us, well, when you score on special teams, 93% of the time you win the game. I'm still waiting to see that number is empirical.
And now the Bucs deciding to take a timeout defensively. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. So the offense readies for a second and four. They come out here in the eye. Another carry for the rookie Elliott. And he'll be and the Buccaneers go ahead and take another timeout. That'll be their second, so one more chance to stop the clock here, and we'll be back. And they're just a couple of yards shy of a first down here on third down.
Hey, boys, we got four down. Here we go. Right at 38.
They'll try and run for it with Elliott. And that play went nowhere. Losing yardage. It'll be back at the 36. A loss of a yard, and it brings up fourth. And here's a big one now. Trying to hold this lead. They're going to go for it here on fourth down. They'll come out in the pistol. They'll run it with Elliott. And he is going to lose yardage here. Ezekiel Elliott not able to get it past the marker. And the Buccaneers defense holds and they get the football back. And now the Buccaneers offense gets set to head back onto the field. So you're right there, but obviously the clock is not your friend. How do you handle this situation?
You're thinking two plays. One, to get yourself in position for the second one. Whether you're able to get into field goal range, or you have to try another deep pass, another Hail Mary. But you're trying to get the first one to a receiver, get out of bounds, and give yourself a chance to set things up for an easier shot at it.
We'll see if they can do it. Might be easier said than done. Well, going into the final play of this game, they knew that they needed some type of a miracle there at the very end, but they couldn't get it done. However, we were treated to really a spectacular affair.
Even though they didn't finish it off, you're exactly right. They took us down to the last play where still you're wondering, could it happen? Possibly, even though we both knew it was a long shot.